Ladies and gentlemen, I want to specially welcome you to Motorsports Manager. I bought this game on the Steam Summer Sale, which is going on right now, in case you haven't heard about it. So if you have Steam, go ahead, check it out, do your queues, get your cards, do whatever it takes. So now, speaking of doing whatever it takes, let's do whatever it takes to win. Alright, let's start a new career. Currency symbol, like, can we use, yeah, American dollars, I mean, date format, month date, do I want, yeah, month, day, year, oh, man, so precise, alright, I don't want to mod my game, I have the GT DLC for this game, but I'm not gonna put any mods to it, kinda cool though, you can have mods, alright. He's an ex-driver. Backstory. I'm an ex-driver from... Where am I from? Continent, North America. Come on, United States. There we go. Yeah, I know this really matters, I guess. Just... What's your pal? Looks like a nerd. Give me that. Alright, that'll work. That'll do no fish air. Pardon me. Sneezy. Alright. Do not enter the verified first now. Commander Sharp. It's kind of a weak surname, but whatever. Choose a team. Let's choose a team. I want the single seater series, GT series, endurance series. It's just single series, just because, you know, it's gonna be another thing a little bit more. World, European or Asian Pacific. Let's just do World Motorsports Championship. Model Championship rules. Racing lasts 20 minutes. Qualifying session lasts 12 minutes. Only races around 35 laps on average, which place more of an emphasis on overall quality. Race ID 4 mile per hour, pit lane, speed limits, stimulation. So this pit stop, all aspects of the car can be worked as soon as during a pit stop, leading to faster decisions to high merit payments. There is a large difference in prize money awarded to the top and bottom teams, awarding the top teams at a greater rate than the smaller teams. Points for top 10. 25, 18, 15, 12, 10, okay, whatever. All teams will find it challenging to score points. Normal width slick tires, the second highest performance tire slicks allow the team to go very quickly around the track. This performance comes at a cost, however, with the tires costing 25,000 per race. Why do they spell tires like that? That just triggers me. Alright, close. I just wanted to see the viewers and whatnot. Let's continue. So we're in the World Championship Series. We have to go to... it's where I pick my select team. Chariot. Expected to finish 10th. They have a high pressure. It's like the, like... I don't want to have like a lot of high pressure on me in the beginning, personally, because like if you lose big, and then with smaller teams, like if you kind of lose it's not a big deal. So let's go. A chariot or a Bronto? I kind of want to do one of those teams. Medium pressure. This guy's low pressure. Let's see here. I do that. Engine supplier hammer. Ability. This would be like the hardest one to go off of. Fuel supplier is medium now. Company is American XCT. Toronto. Well, there's some decent players. So the hammer and MP seem to be the bottom line guys. The top line guys are Imperial Petroleum. Let's just do... Let's start with a small team. Let's do Chariot. Just because I kind of want to build from a guy, from a team. Best in championships. Yeah, 10th. Staff. The bar indicates the skill of the team. Staff related rests. Sponsors. Bar indicates how much money the team is currently making. Sponsors. Okay. Pit crew. Headquarters. Okay, let's have a chariot racing group. We'll continue with them. It'll be kind of hard, but, you know, if we mess up, it won't be such a big deal. So, I'm looking at this from more of a win-win or a lose-lose or a win-lose. Lose-win, you know. Alright, round one. No, GP. This... I need to check to see if these racetracks are actually like in Project Cars and drive them. I did just buy Project Cars 2 as well, but I only have the first Project Cars installed right now because I want to play that one to the most I can, so I can get the most out of that game. It's a fun game, no matter what. Nevertheless, for me. All right. Race objective 6 or above. Bonus $350,000. Doha? Someone's gonna tell me how to pronounce that. Roger, welcome to the race. This tutorial will teach you the most important principles of motorsport management. Sit tight. I'm not wearing a harness in my chair, so that might be a problem. You'll be making high pressure pit stop calls before you know it. These are your two drivers. The aim of the game is to guide them to glory. The higher they finish in the race, the more points you'll get, obviously. Get more points than anyone else, and you'll win the championship. Party. You know. Let's take a look at where our drivers are on the grid. You can focus on them by clicking on their portrait. So is that Sebastian Vettel? I wonder. Now let's see what drivers is qualified. Click on the driver portrait to refocus the camera. Oh, click on this guy. Okay. So Woodford. I think these are real race car drivers too, but I'm not. I don't watch Formula, so I watch like NASCAR and IndyCar because that's all they air locally here in the United States. They don't like to air Formula. We see. Let's get this shit. Woodford, what the hell? Alright, let's focus on Vettel here. I think that's Sebastian Vettel. So, what a dramatic story. Soon, we'll start telling your driver what to do, but first, take a minute to look around and enjoy the view. Drag lift, mount, button, rotate view, scroll wheel, zoom in and out. Okay, so I can zoom out, I can... Oh, okay. So I can actually kind of move with him around the track a little bit, see what he's seeing. Woodford is not doing well. Ah, my gosh. Let's start giving our drivers some orders. When dealing with the driver's trade, there are three important things. We're gonna tires, fuel, intensity. Alright. This car has its own set of tires, which wear down. Yeah. I know how tires work. Each car has its own fuel tank, the bottom number. Example, plus 14, and guess how much fuel you will have at the end of the race if you're carrying your car strategy is this number. This is the only thing that means that you're going to try to fuel before the other race, so it's very important. That's good. So now that we know about tires and fuel, let's change the driver's intensity through the stretch. Depends on where you make quick strategic calls while the drivers are on the racetrack. There are two areas, driving style and engine noise. Driving style impacts how quickly your tires wear out. Attack, push, neutral, conserve. Initially shows how much of an impact it will have on the tires shown. The arrows next to each other wearing through your tires could be useful to make a pit stop sooner, so be careful not to push your drivers too hard. Attack. Which one impacts fuel burn rate, since drivers is either a choice, one burns faster. Your fuel will burn, remember if you run out of fuel for the final lap, your race will be ruined. These buttons, you can set team orders. One position with the race button or priority of one driver with the allow teammate through button. If one of your drivers is aligned with the other, team orders could be the solution. Okay. Smashing your driver is now pushing. There, that was trying to make that three wide. Alright, Woodford should be trying to come to the front in a second. He's gone. Now we're getting some more tinkering with time will help us. Alright. Cool. We also use these shortcuts to adjust the viewing speed. Normal, fast speed, very fast speed, got it. Oh, you have to sit back and watch the race unfold. I don't want to do that. What if Vettel crashes? It's only at normal speed, so... Come on, Woodford. Oh my gosh, Woodford. Fast level set by Jamie, I don't know what I heard. Vettel. Not Vettel, I mean Woodford. Vettel's out there leading, and his teammates being left in the garbage dump. Looks like Vettel could be... he's slowing down. Your driver's tires are looking pretty worn out. Let's bring them in for a pit stop. Let's go see the pit stops. Okay. So confusing right now. They make this so complicated, but I know in real life it's not this complicated. The stank refers to the laps that your driver has done on their current set of tires. It's okay. A very good driver's pace on various tires, which can't go on. Picking which tires to change on it. Point main race is straight either in order to test their compound stopping tires are generally faster but wear more quickly. Green tires are light, right brain or damn track, wet tires. Yep, got it. I learned that from racing. Project Cars. These tires are the fastest we can use at the moment. So let's fit a fresh pair. If you click the park condition jump down, we can check out all the drivers' parts are okay. As a condition level, this shows you the health of each part. Red area near the end bar shows that part's danger zone. I might need to upgrade for that. If a part enters the danger zone, its conditions may drop suddenly. If a part's condition reaches 0%, then it will break. That's not good. Your driver's gearbox is looking a bit dodgy. Why do you guys speak like a British person? I don't like this. To fix a part, click on the fix part button to send it. It to be fixed. This will add some condition back to that part when the pit stop happens. It should be enough to get your car to the finish line. Set the gearbox to be fixed by clicking the fix part button. Got it. Click on the pit strategy drop down. We can set our pit crew strategy. Save. That's just how fast pit stop should be. The fastest the pit stop is, the more chance there is of your pit crew making a mistake, shown by the risk percentage. If the pit crew made a mistake, the car won't brake. It will simply add a lot more time to the that particular stop. If you're in a close battle at the top of the leaderboard, it might be worth taking the risk of a quick stop. Safe. 20% risk is a lot, apparently. The balance shows an estimation of how long your pit stop will take, and which position you're likely to be in when you exit the lane. Okay, well, I mean, of course you're gonna come out in last place. So now when Vettel comes back around, he's gonna pit. Alright. So when will he take his pit stop, is the question. Because I've scheduled him, but sometimes they don't go right away. Sometimes they string it out for a little. Overtake. He's attempting, yeah, but Wood Ford is not doing good. And he should be... that's not the pit road yet. He took 18th place. Good for you. And there he goes in the pit road. Okay. Progress of your fuel, tire, and condition work. If you see any of these icons, it means that your mechanics have made a mistake and that the pit stop is running slower than planned. Let's hope that that one goes off without a hitch. And you're talking British, I don't know. Front jack, rear jack. Oh, the repairing gearbox thing, yeah. Alright, we're gonna go back to Woodford here to catch back up. Oh, it's a new tire that now fitted, we can see. We can also check to see that the gearbox has been fixed by opening the conditions tab. Alright. Well, that's much better. You can choose the condition panel by clicking the condition button again, we're clicking away from the panel. Got it. So now Vettel has to make up all that time and hope that they have to... well, actually, no, it's a 28 lap race, so there is, I think, two mandatory pit stops, if I'm correct. For our other driver, starts feeling neglected. Let's check up on them. Looking at the sector time shows how their lap is going. Each circuit is broken up into three sectors, in case you didn't know that. Unless you're watching NASCAR, which in that case, they just count the full lap. You know, each circuit is broken down into sectors. A white square means they haven't beaten their best time. Green square means that they achieved a new personal best, while purple means they've driven a sector faster than any other driver on the track. So white is bad, green is okay, and purple is great. I think that's what it means. Alongside sectors, pace shows you... yeah, I got it. Has form with fluctuance throughout the race. Has form. Which fluctuates throughout the race. Oh my god, I cannot read that. More consistent driver is, the more stable their form will be. Happier drivers are also more likely to have good form. As if you can say that there's such a thing as form in motorsports. Maybe in motocross, but... or MotoGP, but I'd ask my friend about that, since he drives motocross. So Vil will catch up to the back of the pack, and he'll just get his spot back as people take the stops. He's getting... he's getting a spot, maybe? No, he just dropped his spot. He's taking too many high-risk chances right now. I think he's on... He's on attack right now. To overtake and push. Just because I don't want him to, like, feel like he's being neglected. Biddle, I'm going to put that strategy as conserve. Just because he's running alone, I don't need him blowing himself out on lap 4. I'll speed this up just a little bit here. Biddle doesn't really need to worry right now. Now, is the car's condition looking? Woodford making his move. Got 15th. That's good. That's good. Map is corking away. Map is a corking way of seeing where the rest of the rivals are on the track. Clicking on different drivers in the mini map removes carrots and then. Okay. Picture standing to vision. Otherwise the time isn't too best to meet it. Got it. Ooh, weather forecast, blue and heck. Looks like there's some rain on the way. What are the chances? Yeah, what are the chances? We can also see how much water is on the track by checking the water on your truck. Go figure. Since there's rain to go, we need to change our tires to intermediates. I don't want to do that, really, but just react to whether there's fitting the most. We don't need to do it right away. Like, you just gotta wait till it, like, when it starts. Like, one lap after it goes through, you're tired. Okay. Alright, I'll select intermediate tires. It's up to you. Don't forget to check your condition. Big condition. I think we're okay. Our wings are fine. Still balance? Just to try to... And let's, it's calling for it by lap 6. Alright, we'll do the pit. Oh, it's starting to rain. What do I do? I should be immediately going back to the next speed and check its grip level. When the cars drive, they lay down rubber on it. Yeah, I know. Alright, you need a pit too. You're not gonna make it very far. Let's put some wets on him. His wing needs to be fixed. Can't run without a wing. Now we just do a safe pit stop because we don't need... It's still early in the race. We don't need to worry about that. So both drivers are scheduled to pit. They'll come out together. If I'm correct. If I time this correctly, they should come out together and they can race together. Ford is only at a 5.0 intensity, or happiness, I think, current form. So he's not really liking me. Alright, lap 6 is starting. So these guys will come in. Ford comes in. Oh, perfect pit stop. Alright, Vidal will come in. Oh, it's the same pit crew that services them. Okay. I didn't know that before. So they're gonna come out in the back here, and Woodford, I'm gonna put you back on neutral, and we'll do high fuel burn. You, sir, you can go on high and neutral as well. And here we go. We're in the back. But it's going to be okay because nobody else has pitted. It's going to be the last name Sharp. Okay, is that supposed to be like me? I don't. Must have taken my name I put in. Okay. So I think we'll be okay. Let's just get an overview here. That's cool. So Woodford is actually making up ground because people have had to pit. That's cool. It's very interesting too how this pit lane works because it kind of, the pit road actually kind of cuts the track a little bit. So Woodford is actually making up some progress here. Vittle is still running alone, but Vittle will come back for sure, I know that. He was running, he started on the pole basically. Drivers can be delicate souls, so it's always useful to see what's affecting their race points. Hovering over the cliff will show you what's currently impacting them. Data center? Is that? No. That's not what I want. Continue. Play. Stonking job so far. The rest of the race is up to you. Have a click around and... Okay. So Woodford is in a position to get a top 10. Yeah, so you see right there, the pit lane actually kind of cuts the track a little bit when you come back on. Middle, I'm sorry, dude, but you... Slap 8. I'm not gonna make him push yet. Alright, waters are starting to come off track a little bit. It's still wet though. Woodford is making great ground with those intermediates, and I'm surprised that Middle is not doing very well with those wets. I don't want to pit him again because he just pitted. No, Woodford, you're gonna have to pull it through. Actually nice to see too what everybody else is running right here. Alright, he's gonna he's hanging on to 8. Nah, he'll fell back to 10. That's okay. Condition. No active bonuses, no active. Tires look like 50p pieces again. That's what Woodford is saying, telling me. But you're in ninth place, though. I don't... Alright. On lap 12... On lap 12, I'm gonna bring them in. Both in. Or lap 12, actually... Vittle's just so far behind right now. He needs to get it in gear. Attack, overtake, go. Woodford, I really need that 6th place finish, but... I just had personal best engine too. Cool. So, the tires look like 50. Alright. Let's give Woodford... pit stop. And let's put him on... Slicks? Should I do a soft... Those are soft slicks, I think. It's currently on intermediates, but it's not... There's no water on the track. Not anymore, really. Let's do this. We're gonna gamble. It's gonna need fuel at pit stop, okay. I'm gonna go to hard tire comp. We're gonna fix his tail wing. I think that's his tail wing. And we're going to do a balanced pit stop. And he needs to pit. So Woodford's gonna come in and pit. Vittle, on the other hand, I'm going to keep him out for another 2 laps. Let him push. Alright, let's just speed this up here. And watch Woodford's pit stop to make sure it goes okay. God damn, this is such a big race course. Alright, big circuit, I should say. Vidal's making up ground, that's good. Vidal is saying something. Oh, no, he's not. Alright, everybody else is coming in. Woodford making an excellent pit stop. So Sebastian Vidal now, I'm going to... your conditions seem to be okay for now. Woodford's in 18th place here. He is going to have to gain that ground back on the track here. Alright, let's grab you, Vidal. You need to make a pit stop. We're going to switch to... Oh, this is how many sets of each one would we have. Okay. So I get it. So you get a certain... You get 5 sets of each tires that you get to use. Okay, you can reuse old tower. Okay, I get this. So, pit strategy... I want to go suspension or front wing. He's in 20th place. See, this is... Let's go for suspension. It's going to be... It's going to be a lot... Oh, we can do both. Let's do both. He's already in the back. We'll try to make a fast pit stop. Last place. It's not gonna matter if we make a mistake, but Woodford, flat spotter. Right. Current form, conditions. Okay, 250 miles per hour. Woodford. So Vidal. Oh my gosh, I'm so glad I took that gamble on him. Oh man. He's gonna be so fast now. And he's not gonna have to make a single pit. He's gonna make it to the end of the race. I think. He can make it all the way to the end. Oh my, Vidal does not have to make another single pit stop. And there's no more weather coming. So, Woodford will have to make one stop, for sure. But Vidal can make it. I don't think there's caution in this either. This is so hard. Like, because like, oh man, this made such a long video, but like, oh man, this is so good. Oh, come on, Woodford, come on, come on. You're my gemstone right now. Should we do the old splash and go for Woodford? Because Vidal's going to be fine. Oh wait, he's at 12 and a half laps, or 12.2 now. I'm churning through these tires, boss. Should I start going easy on them? Yeah, take it down a notch a little bit. If you're that worried, take it down a bit of a notch. You've got to keep pushing, though. Behind by 89 seconds. How? Where's the leader? Is he like right behind him? Not really, but like, oh my gosh. Oh no, conditions. The car. Oh man. His brakes are going to be shot by the end of this race. Oh man. Woodford may have to either fuel mileage his way if he can. These guys are going to have to make a stop soon. One, two, yeah, they're all going to have to make a stop. So let's do this. We're going to tell Woodford to pit. We're not going to change the tires. We're just going to do... We have no changes here. Fix. We'll do wings. We'll fix his front rear wings, and we'll do a fast pit stop. It's just wings we're doing. It's just wings that we're doing. Woodford needs to fix his wings to get more aerodynamics. Top 19 starts okay. So this is going to be quite a gamble pit stop. Holt's pitting. Oh man, they're pitting. Can I attack a bit more? I need to get the temperature. You're pitting right now. So after you come out of the pits, I'll change you. Alright, strategy. You may attack. Now if Fiddle does this correct, he can win. He can potentially win this race. Or Woodford can. One of the two. Though I may have screwed myself. I should have maybe kept them on the track a little bit longer. I think I'm just going to let it play out to the end. I think we'll be okay. Can we make it to the end of the race with this much fuel left? No, we can't. We can't. Oh, Woodford. Oh, I said he would keep gas. It said it would give gas, but it didn't. Strategy white. Alright. We're gonna give him some soft towers. Oh man, I screwed this already. Oh man. A few things a bit low, should I back off?
You can serve.
I just gotta get into the finish line. That's all I care about now. Soft tires are on it. Kind of a bit worried about how low. And why is it not giving him fuel? Why is it not giving you fuel? We can't. Just gonna have to make it. Man. He's gonna have to come to pit, but how do we put fuel in the car? Maybe it's purposely making me run out of gas to teach me what happens when it happens. Tire temps feel really high, guys. Not feeling the same boost anymore. Okay, then you can back off just a little bit. I want to pit for fresh tires. Now you can make it. Ah. Oh. I screwed these guys. Oh, we had a pole position and I screwed it up. He's not gonna make it. Please fuel the car up. And they refuse to fuel the car. He's blue flag, which means that he has to give up that spot. Fiddle is up to 19th now, so that's good. He's at 11% on his tires. I can't give you fuel for some reason. I'm sorry, Woodford, but I can't give you the fuel. Give the fuel. Why won't it give you fuel? Oh man. He's gonna run out of fuel here. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. You're out of fuel. No, come hit. I can't. I can't. I think there might be a glitch because it says fuel at pit stop. But it's not giving me the opportunity to feel him that he's out of gas. Viddle is out again? What? Viddle ran out of gas? Just clutching around. Just clutch it. There you go. You'll make it. Viddle will make it. I don't think Woodford will. His tires are out. Oh no. Are they even gonna finish the race? He'll finish. He finished, okay. So I guess maybe I just don't have that option to give fuel. There you have it. So that is my first race. I am not the next free country. But anyway guys, I'm out for reloading and I'll see you guys in the next one. Man, this was not a good race.